Some of you may remember, back in June we got a shop in our local town of Richelieu to sell our ceramics and fibre arts. It's only for 3 months, so we were limited as to what we could do with the space. And we also had zero budget, so I had to get creative with styling the shop. I'm really pleased with how it's turned out, and we've had great feedback. We're sharing the shop with a lovely jeweller called Jap. I've included the link to her website below. We've now got all the products listed on our website too, so if you'd like to take a look, head to studioporiere.com. It's been a juggle getting pieces made on top of everything else, but it's been nice meeting everyone that pops into the shop. Fortunately, I can weave while I'm in the shop, which always elicits plenty of questions from curious passers-by. The recent heavy winds and storms blew a lot of greengages off the trees, so we've been collecting and preserving as many as we can. This greeny-yellow fruit, known as rain-clawed in France, are similar to plums, but a bit tartar. Here are three very simple ways to preserve them. First up, I'm making a batch of jam. Underripe greengages are perfect for this. I've got a kilo of fruit, and I'm adding 250 ml of water. Heat until the fruit is starting to soften, then add in 750 grams of jam sugar. When you reach 105 degrees Celsius, jam temperature, carefully decant into your sterilised jars. A friend gave us her dehydrator, and this is our first time trying it out. It's certainly a very easy way to preserve fruit. The perfect little snack. Finally, I'm making a greengage crumble. I love crumbles, and they freeze well too. Again, I've got a kilo of greengages, and I'm sprinkling on 100 grams of sugar. If yours are riper or you're using a sweeter fruit, you may not need sugar here. For the crumble topping, I have 200 grams of flour, 100 grams of sugar, and 100 grams of chilled butter or margarine. Mix together until you have a breadcrumb consistency. I'm adding in some oats too, as the greengages are very juicy, so I find this helps the texture of the crumble not become a soggy mess. Sprinkle on the top and bake in the oven for about 30 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. Serve with cream, custard, or ice cream and enjoy.
July has been very wet, cloudy, and stormy. We've had some incredibly heavy rainstorms recently, which have highlighted many issues that need to be resolved. Leaky guttering, issues with the roofs, and other rainwater evacuation problems. I managed to do a temporary fix on this one straight away. The aim is to tick off as many of these jobs in the coming months as we move into autumn.
Oh, it's really lashing in sideways.